Okay, chapter 12, part 2. And we begin with a picture of the fabulous Oompa Loompas giving a big shock to the grandmas and the granddads. "They're Oompa Loompas," Charlie told her. "They're wonderful. You'll love them." "Shh," said Grandpa Joe. "Listen, Charlie. The drums are starting up. They're going to sing." "Alleluia," sang the Oompa Loompas. "Oh, alleluia and hooray. Our Willy Wonka's back today. We thought you'd never make it home. We thought you'd left us all alone. We knew that you would have to face some frightful creatures up in space. We even thought we had a crunch of something eating you for lunch." "All right," shouted Mr. Wonka, laughing and raising both hands. "Thank you for your welcome. Will some of you please help get this bed out of here?" 50 Oompa Loompas ran forward and pushed the bed with the three old ones in it out of the elevator. Mr. and Mrs. Bucket, both looking completely overwhelmed by it all, followed the bed out. Then came Grandpa Joe, Charlie and Mr. Wonka. "Now," said Mr. Wonka, addressing Grandpa George, Grandma Georgina and Grandma Josephine, "up you hop out of that bed and let's get cracking. I'm sure you all want to lend a hand running the factory."
"Who, us?"
said Grandma Josephine.
"Yes, you," said Mr. Wonka.
"You must be joking,"
said Grandma Georgina.
"I never joke," said Mr. Wonka. "Now you listen to me, sir," said old Grandpa George, sitting up straight in bed. "You've got us into quite enough troubles and trumbles for one day."
"I've got you out of them too," said Mr. Wonka proudly, "and I'm going to get you out of that bed as well. You see if I don't."
More tomorrow. Chapter 13, How Wonkervite Was Invented.